SOMED, Cervical Cancer Prevention Awareness and Health Matters. Your partner in health matters. Dedicated to promoting awareness of both male and female issues.
Hello everyone, my name is Edna Dapa and welcome to my channel. Today's topic will be the last discussion about causes of abnormal vaginal bleeding that is not attributed to gynecological cancers. We have also learned that an abnormal vaginal bleeding is not a death sentence, but could be an alarm bell to an adverse condition that needs urgent medical attention. There could be more causes of abnormal vaginal bleeding that I may not have mentioned, but I hope the vital points have been discussed to enable us progress to the next phase. Today, I will be speaking about two processes that could cause abnormal vaginal bleeding. They are endometrial or uterine polyps and natural process of menopause. Endometrial polyps are fleshy growths or masses that are localized in the endometrium, the inner liner mucosa lining of the uterine cavity. Uterine polyps are more likely to develop in women who are between age 40 and 50 years old. They may occur after menopause, but rarely are they found in women under 20 years old. Uterine polyps vary immensely in sizes and appear as single or groups. They are usually benign, though some could become cancerous if not treated. Polyps may also cause problems with menstruation and fertility. Sometimes polyps ulcerate, bleed or twist, which may lead to partial or complete tissue death and could be the source of abnormal bleeding. Many women who have uterine polyps may be non-symptomatic, whilst one or more of the following symptoms could be experienced. Irregular menstrual bleeding or periods. Bleeding or spotting between menstrual periods or intramenstrual bleeding. Excessively heavy menstrual periods. Abnormal vaginal discharge. Vaginal bleeding after menopause or postmenopausal bleeding. Bleeding after sex or postcoital bleeding. Uterine polyps are the cause of abnormal bleeding in about 25% of females with the condition. It is not known exactly the cause of uterine polyp in women. However, it may be linked to changes in hormone levels. Certain factors increase the risk of having polyps, and some of such factors include obesity, being perimenopausal or postmenopausal, history of cervical polyps, high blood pressure or hypertension, the use of tamoxifen drug for treatment of breast cancer, places women at a higher risk of developing endometrial polyp. Tamoxifen is used to prevent breast cancer in women and to treat breast cancer in men and women. One of the side effects of this medication is to make the period irregular, causing abnormal bleeding. Diagnosis of polyps starts with menstrual history, including how long the period is and its frequency. Such histories also include any unusual symptoms that are being experienced, such as excessive bleeding or spotting between periods, and if there is any difficulty becoming pregnant. The doctor will also perform a gynecological examination and additional tests. Endometrial polyps are treatable, and medical professionals may recommend a watchful and waiting approach. Polyps can also be treated with medication or surgical removal, although uterine polyps could sometimes return after treatment. Another factor that could cause women to experience abnormal vaginal bleeding is perimenopause, menopause, and postmenopause. These are natural processes that occur in women with age. They are also phases of life when there is gradual decline in estrogen production by the ovaries. Also, the regular pattern and activities of estrogen and progesterone functions are disrupted and the menstrual pattern changes, with some expression of abnormal vaginal bleeding. This is indicative of perimenopause or menopause, and it has no golden age. Perimenopause is the few years preceding menopause, when the ovaries start running out of eggs and begin to release them in an erratic manner. This creates irregular and very unpredictable bleeding or periods that could be expressed as abnormal vaginal bleeding. Menopause is defined as lack of menstruation for 12 consecutive months and a condition when pregnancy can no longer occur naturally. Menopause is the result of a natural decline in hormones and the ovaries stop the release of eggs. Post-menopause is the years after menopause, and it is a milestone that comes with positive and negative effects. Post-menopausal bleeding, when observed, may be entirely harmless. However, it is important to seek professional advice promptly. Some of the causes of post-menopausal bleeding include infection of the uterine lining due to thinning or atrophy of the vaginal lining caused by lower estrogen levels. Side effects of taking hormone medications such as tamoxifen could result in post-menopausal bleeding. Tamoxifen is used to prevent breast cancer in women and to treat breast cancer in men and women. Many women will experience breakthrough bleeding because of taking hormone replacement therapy, HRT. HRT is a form of hormone therapy used to treat symptoms associated with menopause. Women taking HRT to lessen symptoms of the menopausal transition may experience vaginal bleeding as its side effect. The bleeding or spotting is generally light and usually unpredictable. Vaginal atrophy is a factor that could cause abnormal vaginal bleeding in postmenopausal women. Atrophy is the result of changes to the lining of the vagina due to reduced levels of estrogen during postmenopause. The vaginal wall becomes drier during postmenopause, thinner and less elastic, and could lead to breakdown resulting in spontaneous bleeding after menopause or postmenopausal bleeding. In menopausal women, vaginal dryness is quite common and could lead to uncomfortable sex since the vagina does not lubricate well. This could result to postcoital bleeding or bleeding after sex that may also be expressed as abnormal vaginal bleeding. Another condition that could cause abnormal or postmenopausal bleeding is endometrial hyperplasia. It is a disorder of excessive proliferation of the cells of the endometrium or inner lining of the uterus. The condition is because of high level of estrogen or not enough progesterone to counter estrogen proliferating. Bleeding in postmenopausal female requires further investigation because most women with endometrial cancer present with bleeding. 90% of women diagnosed with endometrial cancer reported bleeding before cancer diagnosis. Failure to evaluate postmenopausal bleeding may lead to delayed diagnosis of endometrial cancer. We can see that some conditions are not cancerous, but if left untreated, as in the case of polyp, the disorder could become cancerous. During postmenopausal phase of life, women could become anxious about any form of bleeding from the vagina and are quick to assume something obnoxious. It is incredibly wise to urgently seek medical advice once any form of postmenopausal bleeding is observed. With the knowledge and information from this series, I'm sure we will be able to support our mothers and grandmothers and great-grandmothers on this subject. I hope to see you next time, when I will be discussing abnormal vaginal bleeding due to gynecological cancers. Thanks for watching, and please like and share this video to your friends and family. Also click on the bell to notify you when a new video is released. I will see you soon.